Hello and everybody, welcome back to Black Gun. Today, we have a special guest. It is the Steyr AUG A3M1. I put an aim point pro on here, which is pretty much standard for most law enforcement these days. I'll tell you what, wow, what an interesting exotic little gun this is. I'm gonna tell you something, it's pretty easy to use. I can tell you that it's really accurate because the center of the weight in this bullpup is in the rear. You get a lot of offhand accuracy, a lot of really nice follow-up shots. The muzzle doesn't jump. It was pretty impressive. First time that I even ran a routine like this with this weapon. Now, before we get into this, understand I'm a little bit prejudiced on the AR-15 platforms. It's just an easier platform for me to use. So going to an exotic configuration like this was a pretty big jump for me. My ultimate thoughts are, it's a great rifle. This would be a good patrol rifle. There's no question, since it's been out since the 70s, it's a pretty amazing assault rifle for the Austrian Armed Forces and the other countries that had adopted it. It takes a while to get used to. So let's talk about the negatives first, because I'm sure everybody wants to know the negatives. It's the trigger pull. When you get a bullpup configuration, most of the action is set back here. So this trigger system really relies on a set of mechanics to operate the action here in the rear. And the trigger pack is way in the stock. So it's real blocky. It's really, really difficult to get used to. In the semi-automatic configuration, it's just one pull. In the fully automatic configuration, one half pull is semi, and then if you pull the whole way back, it'll go into full auto mode. It takes a while to get used to. The trigger definitely feels real plasticky, should I say. You're not getting that metal-to-metal sear release you would be used to on an AR platform. But as far as accuracy is concerned, once you get used to that trigger, you can get over that hurdle pretty easily. It is a gas-operated weapon, which makes it very reliable. As far as maintenance is concerned, I don't think that you're gonna have another weapon that's gonna be as easy to assemble and disassemble as this one is. To take this barrel out, you just merely push this button and push it this way, and the whole thing comes straight out. So changing barrels literally takes under 4 seconds. You could put a larger barrel for the smaller barrel. You know, it still keeps a nice compact weapon because of the bullpup design. This is a 16-inch barrel here, and look, I mean, the whole weapon literally just fits in a nice little compact configuration, which, consequently, if you didn't see, operating out of a patrol car, you could get in and out of this gun and use that patrol car for cover without having any type of long barrel getting in the way. So yeah, this gun would work very well for people in law enforcement, most certainly for military. Also, because the barrel changes out quickly, you can turn this into a designated marksman's rifle within seconds. You know, that is if you have an optics that you can put on the pick rails, which I want to get into next. Have an optics that's already pre-sighted for the barrel on your pick rail. You could take that off. You can interchange it with an aim point. You can put on your smaller barrel, and you know, you have a nice compact personal defense weapon. It has a lot of pick rails. You have one here on the side. You have a very long pick rail on top, so you can put all your accessories and accoutrements. The charging handle is on the left. Pretty easy to use. Everything is ergonomically designed for the human body. Your safety, right here. Fire, safe. Safe is white. Fire gets marked red. Your bolt release is right here. Magazine release is right here. Now, this would be on the model that is not Stanag Mag certified or NATO certified. With the NATO magazine, it's a different type of release and it doesn't have a bolt stay. Okay, so understand that if you're gonna get the NATO platform, you're gonna lose some of the functionality of this particular weapon. Now, the shortcoming I said is the trigger. The other thing that I would consider a shortcoming, and it's very hard to get used to, is the magazine exchange, where you would have the push button on the AR, the magazine comes out, you can do your exchange. It's not that easy. As you can see, when I did a magazine exchange, I'm doing it on the run. I had to shoulder the weapon, come up and manipulate this magazine release, get rid of the magazine and put another one in. Now, the plus to that is the weapon's always shouldered, so you don't have to drop it or manipulate it in any way. The negative to it, getting this magazine out with this, with this particular lever, takes a little bit of getting used to and a little bit of training. But if you get over those two small hurdles, you have a pretty impressive rifle. And with that said, I'd like to get back and shoot this a little bit more. So I'll tell you what, we're gonna end the video with a couple more little range trials here with the AUG, and I'll see you guys at the range.